Hello, I'm Charles Warren, and welcome to LCTV's Take 5 Webcast. Some Dubuque citizens are saying no to adopting the 2013 fiscal budget. This would include a 3.19% property tax increase, a 15% water rate increase, stormwater would increase by 25%, and we would see a 9% increase in garbage pickup. The vote to determine whether or not the budget will be adopted takes place tonight. One of Dubuque County Sheriff's deputies was arrested Friday. James Doyle was arrested by the Division of Criminal Investigations. He was charged with third-degree burglary and stalking. The criminal complaint stated that the offense took place between September 2010 and October 2011. It also said the victim was dating Doyle's ex-wife. The complaint said that he called the victim more than 20 times and threatened him. He is also accused of damaging the victim's truck, trailer, and boat. A no-contact order has been set, and Doyle has been relieved of his duties. The Greater Dubuque Development Corporation recently unveiled its new economic campaign called Next.
We just started the Next campaign, What's Next for Dubuque, launched it on March 1st, last Thursday, and a goal is to raise $8.5 million to fund our operations over the next 5 years.
Some of the other major goals of Next are to bring in 3,300 new jobs, increase the average wage, raise the population, and help new construction. The campaign won't forget about those businesses already in Dubuque, though.
Our number one priority is to take care of the businesses that are here. So the employers have already made the choice of being in Dubuque. We have a very robust program and reaching out to them to make sure that they have the potential of growing in Dubuque.
So far, Greater Dubuque Development has raised half of its goal and hopes to raise the rest over the next 60 days. Not only does March bring spring, but Red Cross Month as well. Cascade High School Student Council was eager to participate in this special month. Mr. Brindle, head of the Student Council, expresses how important this event is to the students and the community.
Students actually run the blood drive and help the Red Cross people from setup through the actual taking of the donation of the blood itself to take down at the end of the day.
Today, Red Cross blood services collect and distribute more than 40% of the country's blood supply. In small Iowa towns like Cascade, it is clear how much work goes into making it a huge success. The 30 students worked for hours in preparation, scheduling appointments, helping with the actual gathering of blood, and getting treats for the donors. Events like these make Red Cross Month a huge success across the country. Dubuque's Diamond Joe Casino will be welcoming a new kind of entertainment at the beginning of May. The casino will be hosting a Comedy 10K, a comedy festival. Comedians from across the country can submit entries to compete in front of a panel of judges. The 96 participants will also perform in front of a live audience in hopes of moving on to the semifinals. Each comedian will have a shot at a piece of the $10,000 in prizes. The first placeholder will win the $3,000 grand prize. The event will take place May 1st through May 5th in Dubuque. Well, that's all we have time for. Thanks for watching, and tune in next time for LCTV's Take 5 Webcast.